Welcome back to my channel. It's Erica with Tiny Acorn. I am in the nursery. How long have I been working on this? Oh my gosh, I think over 3 months. Yeah, it's been a project and it is finally done. You guys, I am so excited to share it with you. So stay tuned, give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and don't forget to subscribe. So our sponsor for today's video is Skillshare. You guys know I love Skillshare. If you guys aren't familiar with Skillshare, they're an online learning community with thousands of inspiring classes for curious and creative people just like you and me. So I ended up taking a class recently called The Definitive Guide to T-Shirt Design and Manufacturing by Jeff Staple. So he owns his own clothing line called Staple. So you guys might not know this, but I actually went to school for fashion design and merchandising and got my bachelor's in that. And I have always wanted to have a clothing line. It's been something that's been on the back burner for a while now, but recently I have been really wanting to kind of get this thing going. And so I thought, you know what? It'd be great to start with a t-shirt. And I love how Jeff encourages everyone that takes this class by the end of it to make your t-shirt and then share it with all the other students in the class. Not only are you inspired to make one yourself, but you get inspired by seeing everybody else's designs. So I went out and printed a shirt, you guys. I'm so excited about it. I cannot wait to share it with you guys eventually. It will be for sale on my website, yay! But right now, I'm actually just waiting for the prototype to arrive, but stay tuned because in the future, the very near future, I will be releasing a shirt. But anyways, go take that class. If you guys have ever wanted to, you know, make your own clothes, he talks about the power of the t-shirt and how everything starts with the t-shirt. And so I think that's just such a great place to start if you're wanting to design your own clothes. So I will leave a link down below in the description box for you guys. And right now, the first 1,000 people that click that link will get a free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. And then after that, it's only around $10 a month. So go check it out, you guys. Okay, so let's talk about the inspiration for this nursery. When I was thinking about what I wanted for Monty's nursery, I knew that I wanted to have a nature theme. When I went to look on Pinterest for inspiration, I didn't really find much of anything, to be honest. And so it was pretty challenging kind of piecing this room together. The whole room really centers around this red vintage rug that we have that we got from a rug dealer in Tahoe. And I have a video about that if you guys want to go watch it. But I loved this rug. It used to be in our living room when we lived in San Francisco. There's another video you can watch as our San Francisco house tour. We ended up using a couple of pieces of furniture that were in our living room in our old house that just weren't working for us in our new place. And so when we moved into this house, I was like, okay, I don't want the red rug out in the living room anymore, but I still love it. So where can we put it? And I thought Monty's room was a great place to put it. And the same thing with this gold chair from Article. I just love the combination of the red and the yellow. I think that those colors are very stimulating and I want Monty to feel creative when he's in his bedroom. And so red and yellow are like really good colors for that. But let's just start with the crib. So I actually agonized over which crib to get, what color to get. Should I get metal? Should I get wood? Should I get black? Should I get gold? And cribs are expensive, you guys. It's like $400 sometimes for a crib. I mean, you can find them for cheaper, but the styles that they had weren't really anything that I wanted. So I waited until there was a sale on Wayfair and I couldn't decide between gold or black. And then I ended up going with gold strictly because it was like $75 cheaper. And once I got it, I was just like, oh no, should I have gone with the black one? But anyway, I went with gold. I like it, I think. I ended up putting like a black sheet on the bed to kind of bring in that darker color. So another piece of furniture that I knew we needed was a dresser that would also double as his changing table. I had this really cute little basket for his changing area and I thought I could just set it right on top of the dresser that we got. So I was on the hunt for so long, you guys. looking for the perfect dresser. I was looking on OfferUp, Craigslist, like eBay, everywhere that I could find to try to find the dresser that I wanted. I found one on OfferUp, but it wasn't available anymore or something, like she just wasn't messaging me back. So I ended up finding this white one that had these black handles on it, and it's an antique from the 1800s, which is so cute, but also I was kind of bummed that it wasn't a natural wood color because I really had that idea in my mind that I was gonna do natural wood. I even bought paint stripper thinking, oh, maybe I'll strip it. I asked you guys on Instagram if I should leave it or if I should strip the paint, and a lot of you guys replied that I should strip it, but you guys, I just felt like it was too big of a project for me. And then like once I got it in here with everything else, I kind of felt like the white worked with the space. I was really happy to have like a good dresser for his room that was cute, but also had like a bit of an antique vibe, because that's really what I was going for in this space, was like one of a kind, unique, eclectic, and a little bit antique and vintage vibes too. So we got the dresser in, and then I knew that we needed to get a bookcase for him. So there's only one wall left really that would like fit the bookcase. And unfortunately we had this barn door that was covering his closet that makes it impossible to really have a bookcase on that wall if you want to open the door. I decided, okay, we're gonna have to take the barn door off. So we took the barn door off. We ended up selling it, actually making a little bit of money, which is great. I ended up hanging up another curtain similar to the ones that are on both of his windows in here, and I used that to cover the closet. We put a beautiful secondhand bookcase in here. It's kind of one of those leaning bookcases, which was perfect because I wanted something that was really low profile because of the fact that it's so close to the door when you're entering into his room. I didn't want anything to be like right there, you know, blocking the entrance in. So it ended up being so perfect, you guys. I love how it turned out. Thankfully, my intern Eva put it all together for me and helped me style it up. I just love the way that it turned out. I have a couple favorite little pieces on the dresser. One of them is this cowhide carrier tote thing that I'm going to put art supplies in when Monty gets a little bit older and he starts coloring and stuff. I think it'll be perfect for that. And I got that at a flea market. And then I actually also got these cute little vintage block letters that spell his name, Montana. There's a lot of special pieces on this dresser. There's some things from my great-great-grandma, one of her old slates. Also a paint by number of a monkey that my grandma made. Yeah, there's a lot of special things here, and I'm excited to share all of those with Monty as he gets older. One of the other pieces of furniture in here is this cart behind me. So we had had this cart in our old bathroom in San Francisco, and it really comes in handy in Monty's room. Since I couldn't put a plant on the dresser, I thought it would be nice to have on the rack back here. And then I also wanted to have diapers really handy so that we don't have to worry about opening and closing the drawer to get a diaper out, especially in the middle of the night. And especially because these antique drawers do not slide very smoothly. You need like both hands to pull it out. So I knew that we were gonna need a diaper solution that was kind of like tucked away to the side, but still like very available and easy to pull whenever we needed it. So I have his diapers on the top. And then in the middle rack, I have like a little basket for his shoes and socks. And then on the bottom rack, I have some of his baby blankets. So I felt like that was perfect to kind of tucked away back behind the chair. So one of the major things for this room that I had a hard time with was this gallery wall behind me. I knew I wanted to do a gallery wall, you guys. So thankfully Eva stepped in and helped me. She's my intern. I don't know if I told you guys that already. But she's super sweet, and I believe God sent her to me seriously just to finish Monty's room because I was so overwhelmed with having to do it all by myself. So doing this gallery wall, I had a bunch of pictures that I knew I could use, but I didn't know if I should use. We started out with the antlers, which are Jason's grandpa's. So we hung those up. I also have behind me a shadow box. That was like the second thing that I knew for sure I wanted on the wall. After that, we kind of started just playing with the pictures and where everything would go. We had a whole setup that we liked. And then like the next day, I was just kind of in here and I'm like, oh my gosh, this wall looks so busy because it has like the shiplap and then it had all the pictures and then it had the feather banner. And I was like, this isn't working. Like something's gotta give. And so I thought, you know what? The feather banner can go on the wall with the crib. But yeah, I really liked the simplicity of the wall with the crib. I wanted to make the shiplap wall a little bit more simple. So we kept most of the elements of it. We swapped out a couple of pictures, and I think it all ended up coming together in the end and working out really nicely. So yeah, this room has a lot of really sentimental, special pieces in it. Has a table from my mom, who got it from her grandmother. It has lots and lots of pictures from my own grandmother and even Jason's grandpa's antlers and just lots of really special pieces that I am so happy to be able to put in Monty's room. I love how this room came together in the end. It feels good when I'm in here and I want to be in here. Yeah, it feels like an adult nursery. I don't know. No, it doesn't. It just feels kind of like adultish in the nursery. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope it was enjoyable for you guys to see how this nursery turned out. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe. Also, stay tuned, right? Because I am releasing some t-shirts. Woo! Soon. I'm going to do it soon, you guys. I just don't know exactly when because I'm waiting for the prototype and whatnot, but they're gonna be available for purchase on my website. Yay! So in the meantime, go find me on Instagram at tiny_acorn. I'm sharing lots of outfit inspiration and other things over there. All right, have a wonderful day, and remember, you're beautiful just the way you are. Bye.